Namaste Bhai. So my topic is that Purvottara Mimamsa Yoga Aikyashastram. The topic itself is that we all know that the Vedanta system itself is considered as a Uttara Mimamsa. So there is another system called Purva Mimamsa. So that is also, it talks about the karma, where in Uttara Mimamsa we discuss about the Brahman. So now in according to the Vishishta Advaita Vedanta, we consider as both the Purva Mimamsa and Uttara Mimamsa are considered as a single sect, not a different philosophy. Both come under the same philosophy. So I will go with some, what is the Pramanam? So in Vishishta Advaita Vedanta, Ramanujacharya describes that there is a Bodhayana Brahma Sutra Vritti. The Vrittikara says that Samhita Medat Sharirakam Jaiminiyena Shodasa Lakshaneneti Shastraikatva Siddhi. So he gives a clue that there is a unity between the Purva Mimamsa and Uttara Mimamsa. So by taking the cue from Bodhayana Vritti, so Ramanujacharya also said that Mimamsa Shastram starts from Athato Dharma Jignyasa and end with Anavritti Shabdat, Anavritti Shabdat. Actually, in normal circumstances, we say Vedanta starts from Athato Brahma Jignyasa. The first sutra of the Mimamsa, Purva Mimamsa, is Athato Dharma Jignyasa. So this, so by giving this statement, there is no other justification. There is one or two justification is available in the Sribhashya of Ramanujacharya. But this has actually opened up many kinds of questions. So I will list out the questions, and then we will see how the Vishishta Advaitin responds to these questions. So the first one is that Athato Dharma Jignyasa, from the starting of Athato Dharma Jignyasa till the Anavritti Shabdat and Anavritti Shabdat, it is completely a single Mimamsa philosophy. So then this will open up many questions. So these are all the five important, 7 important questions which has been directed against the Vishishta Advaitins. So what are this? Is obvious Vichara Bheda, the discussion. In the Purva Mimamsa, you discuss about the karma. In the Uttara Mimamsa, you talk about the Brahman. Completely different two things. Kartra Bheda, Purva Mimamsa has been ascribed to Jaimini. Uttara Mimamsa has been ascribed to Vedavyasa. And then Vishaya Bheda, it talks about the karma and the phalam of the karma. And then here it talks about the Brahma, about the moksha. Maybe the Vishaya, the phalam is also different. Prayojanam, especially the prayojanam. Prayojanam is here the prayojanam is only Surgadi Alpa Phalam. In Vedanta, it is Brahma Phalam, completely different. Adhikari Bheda, there who wants to know about the karma, wants to know, get the Dharma Phalam, then they can go for that. And who wants the moksha has to go for Vedanta. So in Anupayoga is that what is the need for a mumukshu to go and study the Mimamsa, Purva Mimamsa, and what is the need for a Purva Mimamsa who wants to know about the karma to read about the Brahman. And then Paraspara Artha Virodha, even Badarayana in his Advaita Vedanta himself condemns Jaimini in many places. And then if they are only one Shastra, then how can it become, how this condemnation of Jaimini can happen? So this is, so by these things, so they are saying that how two Mimamsa, which is completely different in all these aspects, can become one. So now we see the each and every, so these are all the easily understandable what I have said, that is written in the simple Sanskrit. So this is Vishaya Bheda, so Dharma Swarupam Pratipaditam, in that Vishaya is Dharma, and here the Vishaya is the Brahman, and same way Prayojanam in all these things. So we come to the Samadhanam. So what are the Samadhanam given by this? The first one is the Vichara Bheda. The discussion is something different. But actually, the Vishishta Advaitin says like that, Swadhyayo Adhyatavya. This is the first vidhi which we get from the Veda, that you have to do the Adhyayana. Adhyayana means what? Entire Veda only. It is not restricted to only Karma Kanda or Jnana Kanda. Because it does not, the vidhi does not say, that means the vidhi means the injection. Injection does not say you have to study only Karma Kanda or Jnana Kanda. It says you have to study your prescribed the Veda Bhaga. That means it includes everything. So from that, we can say that the Vichara is about the entire Veda Bhaga. So that includes both Karma Kanda and Jnana Kanda. So Mimamsa, it is nothing but Pujita Vichara. The Vichara about the Vedartha. So then, who wants to initiate, the person who initiates to understand what is told in the Veda has the Samanya Jignyasa, that is that what are the things told in the Vedas. So then he initiates himself into this Mimamsa Shastra. And then the both important thing, you have said it talks about the Dharma and the other one talks about the Brahman. But if you see there is a commonality between these two things. What is the commonality between these two things? Both are only known through Shruti. There is no other pramanam to explain what is Dharma and there is no other pramanam to explain what is Brahman. So these two are the two things which actually has been prescribed by the Vedas only, which you have to know through the Vedas. So you can easily correlate, there is a similarity between these two. There is a oneness that they are the only thing, they are the things which can be identified through only Shruti. So this is, so that for this also one can initiate himself into the vichara. Third one, then there is another question put forth, Bhinna Kartrayoho. It has been written by someone, how two different people talk about the same thing. Then we have also many things that many two peoples can also do a single thing. Many granthas are attributed, single grantha can be attributed to many people. For example, Kashika Vritti. The Kashika has been written by two people, Vamana and Jayaditya, but still you consider as a single grantha. And the great example is Kadambari. Kadambari has been written by both Banabhatta and his son. But still, two karta is there, but still there is, the attribution is to the single text. Yeah, generally, yes. There are many texts available. It is not that, so many people can also form a single thing. And then, and also there is another, in Purana, you can also see that Jaimini is a disciple of Bhagavan Vyasa. So they might have an understanding that you can do the karma vichara and I will do the brahma vichara. So like that, it is also possible. So you can say that Bhinna Kartrutvam is not a prayojaka. And then Paraspara Aniyogi. So this is the important thing. So most of the case, what happens is that why Purva Mimamsa is not applicable to the Uttara Mimamsa? Because Purva Mimamsa talks about the karma and it lists out so many nyayas. Each and every adhikarana talks about the nyaya, but all the nyayas are not applicable in the Uttara Mimamsa, that means in the Vedanta. Then how can, if these the things which have been said in the Purva Mimamsa cannot become applicable in the Uttara Mimamsa? Just, I will finish. So then they say that there are some things, the nyayas can be applicable. What are all the adhyayas, the nyayas of the each and adhyayas can be attributed in each and actually maybe in the Gunobasamhara Pada, in the Tritiya Adhyaya, most of the things have been used. And I have listed out what are all the pramanas which we can use in this thing. And then the foremost question, the only one question I will give the answer of for this question and I will stop. So the Atishaya Purusharsa Prapti. So there is, normally, if in other Vedanta, what they say that you initiate yourself in the Vedanta because Atishayita Purusharsa Prapti. You know that everything is, whatever is achieved through a Kriya cannot give a sustainable phalam. But so that is the logic. So then you initiate yourself, this karma is not required. So then you have to go for something which you have to know, which gives the ultimate, the Niratishaya phalam, the ultimate moksha. So then, by having this kind of a logic, one can initiate himself into a Vedanta, directly into the Vedantic studies. So why, what is the need to study the karma mimamsa, pura mimamsa? So then the answer is that, even to know that this karma mimamsa is very much required to know that the karma is cannot give that much kind of a phalam. Why? Because there are some verses, akshayagam havai chaturmasya yajanaha, apama soma mamritama, even karma gives you moksha. Like that words are there. So without knowing what is the intended meaning of that karma, people may get carried away by that, even this karma can give me the moksha and get into the tangle. So to avoid that, so first you know what is the karma swarupa, then you can initiate. Then after that, you can initiate yourself in the Brahma Jnanam, in the Brahma Vichara, because according to the Vishishta Vedanta, the karma is nothing but not the dharma which we say, it is a Bhagavad Preeti. So then, once you know that these are all the, that means the things which you do, so that Bhagavan become satisfied with you and give you the phalam. And then, after that, you can also analyze that, oh, if the Bhagavan himself is so much powerful to give this kind of a phalam, then how he will be? Then automatically you will get the initiation of knowing the Brahman. And if you, I'll finish it in 1 minute. So if you relate the both the Mimamsa. In Purva Mimamsa, actually in the in the modern times, we are studying about the 12 adhyayas of the Purva Mimamsa. But there is four another adhyaya which is called Sankarsana Kanda. In that Sankarsana Kanda, the Jaimini also, it is also attributed to the Jaimini only. So it is not Dwadasha Lakshani, it is Swadasha Lakshani, the 16 adhyayas of Purva Mimamsa. So in that till 12th adhyaya, karma swarupa, what the swarupa of karma has been has been described. But after that, it talks about the phala data, that means the devata who is giving that phala. And then it says in the last, it ends with tad brahma iti it used the word brahman, ends with the brahman, the word with brahman. And then athato brahma jignyasa, if you relate that, then you get the continuity of also, because of the tradition is not followed, we miss that four kanda. That's why we think this is different and this is different. So by this, so there is nothing different between two Vedanta. And then one small question, I'm taking time. Then why Shankara hasn't used this? Why Shankaracharya has not, why he doesn't merge the two Vedanta? I think of one thing. The thing is that when a person is initiating in the Advaita Vedanta, in the Bhashya itself, in the first Bhashya itself, everything is mithya. That means there is only one thing should be satyam, other thing cannot be mithya. If you take the Purva Mimamsa, it talks about the karma and the satyatvam of the karma, then it will make you to think about the dvaita. Okay, so then your initiation cannot happen, because once the dvaita happens, then if you take the continuity with the Uttara Mimamsa, then you cannot say you are going to reject dvaita. Because Purva Mimamsa talks about dvitvam and Uttara Mimamsa is condemning that. Then your grantha cannot have two contradictory views in a single thing. But in Vishishta Dvaita Vedanta's case, it is not a problem, because the karma is part of the Parabrahma, who gives also the karma and also the moksha. So there is a continuity. But in Advaita Vedanta, you know, so there is no need to merge them like this. Okay, so this is one thing I took off. Thank you for the...
Thank you very much. We